I'm thirsty.
I don't think you should drink that. It looks bad for you.
Nonsense. It makes me feel great. Smarter. More aggressive. I feel like I could. Like I could. Take on the world.
Look, Hoagie, it's a hamster. Just what I need for dissection lab tomorrow.
I think I need that for the band, Laverne. You know, like we could bite its head off or whatever.
Hands off that hamster.
Friend of yours, Bernard?
He belongs to Weird Ed Edison, and it looks like he's brought us a note. It's from my old friend, Green Tentacle. He says that Purple Tentacle's mutated into an insane genius, and Dr. Fred's going to kill them both. I thought I was free of Dr. Fred and those crazy Edisons forever. But now I know that I must go back to the mansion. Okay, we'll spread out commando style. Laverne, you go secure the area behind those double doors. Hoagie, you take care of upstairs reconnaissance. I'll maintain command HQ here in the lobby.
What are we looking for?
We've got to find where Dr. Fred is holding the tentacles.
This better not take too long. I've got an anatomy final tomorrow.
And I've got a show to set up later tonight. If I'm late, I don't get to test the drums.
If I know Dr. Fred, he's got the tentacles tied up in his secret lab. Question is, where's his secret lab? That one looks like it's from a local hardware store. Help wanted. Lab assistant. hard-working, moronic drone needed to assist genius with experiments. High school diploma not required. Help wanted. Lab assistant. Hard-working, moronic drone needed to assist genius with experiments. High school diploma not required. Gee, Dr. Fred doesn't have a penny. Always make sure they get your good side. Aha! A secret passage. This is all too easy.
Laverne, how'd you get upstairs?
Am I upstairs? I got lost.
Seen any tentacles?
What's a tentacle?
Oh, just something I whipped up in my spare time. Made good pets, actually. Until one of them tried to take over the world. Had to tie the little buggers up in the basement.
Good thing you told us that.
Yeah, Bernard wanted us to set them free.
Thank God you weren't that stupid. Did you say Bernard?
Okay, you're free to go.
Thanks, Bernard.
Yes, thank you, naive human. Now I can finish taking over the world.
Wait!
Oh, yeah. Now I remember. He's incredibly evil, isn't he?
I'll try to talk him out of it.
Well, what possible harm could one insane mutant tentacle do?
Leaping lab rats!
Dr. Fred!
What have you done this time, you meddling milquetoast? Now Purple Tentacle is free to use his evil mutant powers to take over the world and enslave all humanity!
Whoops!
Our only hope now is to turn off my sludge-o-matic machine and prevent the toxic mutagen from entering the river!
Isn't it a little late for that, Doctor?
Of course! That's why I'll have to do it! Yesterday! To the time machine!
This is all your fault, Bernard.
Behold, children! The Chronogen!
Doc, can't you just send Bernard?
No, you must all go to increase the odds that one of you will make it there alive!
Have any people ever been hurt in this thing?
Of course not. This is the first time I've ever tried it on people. Well, I'll be.
Bernard, float over here so I can punch you.
This must be that Woodstock place Mom and Dad are always talking about.
What could it all mean?
I don't know. I don't want to know.
Die. Die.
We may not live to see yesterday.
I'm sure Dr. Fred wouldn't have done this if it weren't safe.
After all, he is a doctor.
It works! I can't believe it! And they said imitation diamond wasn't good enough.
Uh-oh.
Order jewels.
What happened to Hokey and Laverne?
I knew I should have bought a real diamond.
Are they alive?
My dials say that the larger specimen landed 200 years in the past, and the other is stuck 200 years in the future.
Well, hurry up and bring them back.
I will, as soon as I get a new diamond. Then all your buddies have to do is plug in their respective chronogons and...
Plug them in? Where is Hoagie going to find an electrical outlet 200 years in the past?
Yes, well, he'll be needing my patented super battery then, won't he? Now, where did I put those patented super battery plans of mine?
Plans? How are we gonna get Hoagie plans?
Don't worry me with details, boy. Just help me find the plans. They're in this house somewhere.
Now what am I going to do?
I think I made myself perfectly clear. Step one, find plans. Step two, save world. Step three, get out of my house. Let's get crackin'. Maybe I put them upstairs. That's got to be it. Upstairs!
Yoo-hoo! Dr. Fred?
The plans! The plans!
This beautiful 4,000 carat diamond can be yours today for the special rock bottom introductory price of $2 million. The number to call is 1-800-STAR-WARS. Don't miss this amazing once in a lifetime opportunity.
There's a whole lot of keys on here.
It's useless. No one will ever be interested in my design, so I'm ending my novelty inventing career right here in this tacky motel. How appropriate. I can't even do this right.
Hi, my name's Bernard. What's yours?
Dwayne. Isn't that depressing?
You haven't seen any plans for a super battery around, have you?
Super battery? That sounds even worse than the things I come up with.
Maybe I can help cheer you up.
Oh, I can hardly wait.
Let's discuss philosophy.
Okay, here's my philosophy. Life is completely pointless, especially mine.
Why do you say that?
I'm a novelty goods designer by trade. I've come up with some fabulous ideas. The exploding lollipop, itching powder gum, and reverse 3D glasses, to name a few. The problem is, no one likes my designs. I send them all over the world and no one responds. I just wish someone would say they liked one just once. Oh, woe is me.
I like your design ideas.
Well, I didn't mean you.
Nice music they pipe in here, huh?
It's from the Elevated Classics series. It seems like this one tune has been on all day. I've never been so depressed in my life.
Never mind. Green!
Bernard!
What are you doing up here?
Well, I couldn't stop Purple, and he's gonna go out and conquer the world, and I'm afraid of what he'll do if he catches me, if Dr. Fred doesn't find me first. Does that answer your question?
Yeah. Hey!
What's up, Bernard?
Wanna help me save the world?
I'm afraid to leave the room. In fact, I don't think I can even move from this spot. Purple scares the daylights out of me.
You haven't seen Dr. Fred's plans for a super battery around, have you?
No, just these world domination plans of Purple's. Any of Fred's plans would probably be in his office or the lab.
What do you suppose Purple's up to now?
Well, he wants to take over the world, so I figure he's up to something devious.
Conducting cryogenic experiments on small animals?
I wouldn't doubt it. But I was thinking more along the lines of politics.
How does a tentacle sit in a beanbag chair?
Oh, that part's easy. It's getting back out of it that's hard.
How's your new band doing?
Green tea and the sushi platter? We're doing great! We've decided to really capitalize on our strongest quality as a band.
Intoxicating three-part vocal harmony?
Volume, man, volume! We have a chance to win a Grammy Award as the loudest new band. We're pulling out all the stops.
Are you working on an album?
Yeah, we're doing a CD called Rap on the Forehead. I've got a few tracks hooked up through the stereo if you want to hear them.
Weren't you looking for a new guitarist a while back?
Yes, but we decided to go with a guy who plays power tools instead. We can generate a lot more sound that way.
Have you gotten any airplay?
No, we're a little too experimental for most radio stations, but we have a huge following in the club scene.
That's great.
Yeah.
See you later.
Yeah! Good luck in saving the world, B-Man!
Wow! This is loud! Where did Dr. Fred go? Hey, aren't you Weird Ed Edison, the paramilitary nut?
Why, yes, Hey, do I know you?
Yeah, I'm Bernard Benulli. I broke into your house 5 years ago, kidnapped your hamster, broke into your piggy bank.
No, doesn't ring a bell, but I can't remember much about that period anyway. My psychotherapist thinks something traumatic happened to me back then that I'm blocking out.
So you gave up the crazy military commando thing?
I'm much better now. I don't have those bad thoughts anymore. Now I collect stamps.
That's quite a nice collection. Can I have it?
No. I mean, no. They mean a lot to me. Sometimes I think they're the only friends I've got.
Are all your hobbies this fascinating?
I don't have any other hobbies. These stamps are my whole life. If anything were ever to happen to them...
Nice hamster. Does he do tricks?
No, he just sits there. I used to have a really smart hamster, but something happened to him.
What happened to the old hamster?
I don't remember. When I try, all I can think of is a flash of light and this horrible sound.
That hamster really should get some exercise.
Well, Dad puts him to work down in the basement sometimes. But then he starts sweating. And then he gets wet, and then he gets cold, and then he refuses to work.
Your dad or the hamster?
Are you making fun of me?
No,
I get upset when people make fun of me.
I just meant...
Oh, it makes me so mad. I just want to... Relax. I want to relax. I'll be okay if I just focus on my stamps.
Well, hope I didn't get you too excited. Bye.
Peace be with you.
Hey, wanna see a neat trick?
Sure.
Neat, huh?
My Pony Express stamp. You ruined my Pony Express stamp. Not to mention 5 years of therapy. Get out of my room.
Jeez, what a grump. You should really try to find some outlet for those... negative feelings.
Get out of here. Hey, you fixed it. I guess I can forgive you now.
Sometimes I do stupid stuff and I don't even know why. As if my body were being controlled by some demented, sadistic puppet master.
Well, we all feel that way sometimes.
Thank you. Hey, boy, you missed the party.
You and the clown were having a party?
No, last night. At the Novelty Good Salesman's Convention. I tell you, we novelty good salesmen know how to have a good time.
Nice cigars.
I roll them myself. Oh, want a cigar?
Sure, lay one of those Havanan babies on me.
Thought I was gonna blow your head off there, didn't you? Well, you were right! Shouldn't smoke. It's a bad habit. That cracks me up every time.
Hi. Don't sneak up on me like that.
What are you up to?
I locked my keys in the car.
I don't see your keys in the car.
Actually, I lost them somewhere.
If you're locked out, why break into the trunk?
I have a spare set of keys in there.
Here, perhaps these are your keys.
Where? Gimme. Hey, thanks, pal. Keep the crowbar.
Thank you, masked man.
What sort of person would carry around this many keys?
Soaking wet. Ooh, 1977.
goo. Got the plans.
Quick, we have to flush them to Hoagie.
How did you get over there?
My ingenious super battery design, please.
You really flushed them?
Yes.
Down the toilet?
No, through time. Using the highly sophisticated time flux hydraulic vortex chamber I've installed in each chronogen, you can flush small inanimate objects to each other through time. Flush small inanimate objects to each other through time.
Hello? Dr. Fred, can you hear me? Drat.
Did you hear something?
No. Let's see if what's-his-name catches on.
Oh, great. I'm stuck in colonial times. Tentacles are taking over the world, and now the toilet's backing up.
Okay. Come over here. It's your old pal, Dr. Fred.
Dr. Fred? How'd you get in there?
I want you to pick up those plans you see in the chronogen, Hoagie. Bring them to Red Edison. He's my great, 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 great grandfather. He'll know what to do.
You need the plans to make a super battery so you can plug in your chronogen.
Okay, if you say so, Bernard.
Good boy. Does he have any experience with electronics?
Well, I once saw him take 3,000 volts directly through his head without batting an eye.
Didn't he pass out?
Well, he was already passed out when it happened.
Time for me to save the world, I guess. I'll just run to the chronogen.
There's something in the chronogen.
Don't get your curls in an uproar. Excuse me, Mr. Washington. Aha! Get away from that. It's a good thing I finished in there quickly. Now scram! They just don't make founding fathers like they used to. Here I am, don't get your curls in an uproar. Excuse me, Mr. Washington. Boy, what a mess.
Sounds like the cat's caught a moose up there.
How about an amendment that the president has to be a human being?
Please, this is serious business.
You're right.
I'll use the chronojohn.
So as soon as Hoagie gets that battery working, we're set.
I'm afraid not. We still need a diamond for the main unit. And your friend in the future needs power too, if she's still alive.
Alive?
Get me out of here. I like trees and everything, but this one has got to go.
Sorry to do this to you, little fella, but it's for the future of the whole planet. Decaf wouldn't help there. Decaf wouldn't help there.
Thanks. I needed a little pick-me-up. Must open safe. Must sign contract. Must provide for family.
Ted is red. See red Ted.
I thought glow-in-the-dark fake doo-doo was such a good idea.
Hey, there's a letter here for you.
For me? probably another rejection slip. Oh, well. You're brilliant. What a novel design. Come to Baltimore at once.
British are coming.
Huh? I don't see anything.
Oh, never mind. Hi there.
What can I do for you, kid?
Has anyone ever told you you look like Don Pardo?
That's strange. My wife says I look like Charles Lawton. So, want another cigar?
Okay, but only if you promise not to light it this time.
Would I do a thing like that? I don't get it. Get lost, kid.
Hi, Horsey.
Oh, hi yourself.
Wow, you can talk.
Wow, so can you. What a coincidence.
I didn't think horses could talk.
Maybe they just never had anything to say to you. Ever think of that?
You mean horses have been snubbing me my whole life?
Well, if you want to put it that way.
Is this some kind of a trick?
I don't do magic. I'm just a horse.
Nice teeth.
Thanks. I paid quite a bit for them.
Did I mention how great your teeth look?
Thanks again.
What's a nice horse like you doing in a place like this?
Hey, I live here. What are you doing here?
I'm trying to get back to the future and save the world.
The future, huh? And I thought that Franklin guy was off his nut.
Well, I gotta go.
See you later.
Ahem. The LALR compiler is constructed by the following method. First, develop a rigorous elective grammar. If the elements have NP completeness, the crunchy factor can be ignored. Blah, 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 blah. Whoa. Just looks like a regular hammer to me, but then I'm no scientist.
Hey, that's a left-handed hammer, you know. I invented it myself. Was for my ungrateful slob of a left-handed son. Oh, well.
Hmm.
What's this? Help wanted. Moronic drone. Assist genius. Yada, yada, yada. Well, I'm the only genius around. And you look dumb enough. So pick up your lab coat and get to work. Super battery, eh? Brilliant design. Sometimes I amaze myself. Now all I need is oil, vinegar, and some gold.
The water's all sudsy now. Hi there, mister.
Franklin, Ben Franklin, soon to be known as the inventor of electricity.
Do you know Red Edison? He's a scientist guy, too.
Red Edison? A scientist? He's just an innkeeper who pretends to be a scientist, and he's not very good at doing either one. I can't believe Washington and Jefferson picked his inn of all places to write our Constitution.
Shouldn't you say, the discoverer of electricity?
You think the ultimate power in the universe is just under some rock waiting to be discovered? Ha! I, Ben Franklin, am going to summon power from the sky by sheer force of genius!
You are truly whacked, Ben.
Huh, that's what they said about the man who invented bifocals.
Wasn't that you?
Good point. Guess they were right.
I wonder what Red would say about that.
Who cares about that crackpot?
I need Red to help me save humanity.
So he's a missionary now, eh? Well, why not? Can't be any worse at that than he is at inventing.
So where's this Red guy at?
Down in his secret lab, of course, neglecting his guests.
What's so bad about Red?
What can you say about a guy who spent the last 4 years perfecting a left-handed hammer? He's insane! And he steals other people's inventions, too, before they can even apply for the patent. Not that I'm bitter.
Aren't you the $100 guy?
The $100 guy, not bad.
Well, see ya.
Carry on.
boy, it's sure quiet in here. I wonder if there might be any ideas worth discussing in the suggestion box. Maybe somebody should take a look.
I say, lads, I have an idea.
Does it have anything to do with starting a fire?
No. I was thinking it's about time we open the suggestion box. Don't you agree?
Sure, George, if you say so.
Yes, whatever you think is fine with us.
Excellent.
What's he thinking? No one of any importance has been here all day. What could be in the suggestion box?
Perhaps he intends to suggest something himself.
Oh. Ah, here's a suggestion. It says, George says that every American should have a vacuum cleaner in their basement. What do you think, gentlemen?
Whatever you say, George.
Your name's on it. I'm sure you must have a good reason for suggesting it.
Yes. It's strange. I don't quite... Well, I'm sure I had a reason for it. If there are no objections, we shall add it to the Constitution immediately. No? Good, and so shall it be law.
What's a vacuum cleaner?
Excuse me.
Yes?
Whoa, you're like George Washington.
Very much like him, according to my wife, Mrs. Washington.
Awesome.
Indeed.
Weren't you president or something?
Yes, I expect to be chosen president unanimously. I'm very well connected. Do you think I should be the ecology president or the education president?
Depends on how many cherry trees you've chopped down.
Well, I am quite the adept tree cutter. Men still tell tales of my youthful prowess.
I bet you've lost it. You couldn't cut down a tree to save your grandmother.
Lost it, have I? Why, I'd show you a thing or two if there were a cherry tree nearby. But as you can see, there... Oh, well, what do you know? There is a cherry tree out there. Well, let's go chop the sucker down.
I said come down from there at once!
Try to understand... I'm stuck in this...
Voila!
You're quite a man.
Yes, I know.
Fathers are driving me nuts. Flag design changes every 5 minutes. Well, as soon as I'm done with this, I'm making them a flag, ready or not.
Get me out of here! I haven't done anything.
Well, you must have done something or you wouldn't be here now, would you? You'd be out in the lobby with your tentacle owner, getting dressed up for the human show.
Owner? No one owns me!
Gosh, no owner, you say? Well, don't worry about it. I'm sure someone will come adopt you before we have to put you to sleep.
Damn that Dr. Fred.
Hey, she knows the Edison family motto.
Thank you. Dr. Fred, is that you?
What? You're nuts. There hasn't been a Fred in the Edison family for 200 years. The last Fred was such a shame to the whole family, not to mention the whole human race.
Well, who are you then?
I'm Zed Edison. That's my wife Zedna, and my son Ved.
Nice to meet you. Where am I?
You're in the ancestral home of the once proud Edison family. We were once the masters of this house, just as humans were once the masters of Earth. Now we are the servants, the pets.
And not very good at either one, I might add.
Oh, get bent, you overdressed nightcrawler.
How do I get out of here?
If I knew that, do you think I'd be here?
What's this about a human show?
It's a degrading farce. That's what it is. These slimy tentacles put humans in humiliating little costumes, do sickening things to their hair, and then force them to parade their ridiculous talents in front of unqualified judges who are paid off weeks in advance.
Didn't get in, eh?
They said macrame wasn't a talent. Pointy-headed goons.
I heard that.
I'm tired of talking now. It's been a long day, and I'm only human.
Yoo-hoo, Mr. Tentacle Guy.
What?
Ooh, I don't feel so good. I think I'm going to throw up all over.
Uh-oh. Time to visit Dr. Tentacle.
Well, well, what have we here?
I feel pukey.
Indeed. All right, now hold still.
Are you gonna use your scalpel?
No, of course not.
Darn. Do you want to use mine?
No.
What? What?
Just as I suspected.
What?
There's nothing wrong with you, human.
What a letdown.
Well, I'm late for the show. I'll send your keeper back for you. Oh. Sit. Stay. Good boy.
They've got the spleen mixed up with the liver. Oh, I've got plenty of those at home. Hi, I'm
Ooh-wee, you are one ugly human.
Excuse me?
Man, I'm not kidding. You are just about the homeliest Homo sapien I've ever seen.
Thanks. You ain't so hot yourself.
I never said I was, but sheesh, have you taken a look at yourself lately? I mean, your hair alone is gonna give me nightmares. Not to mention your teeth, your clothes, your one eye that's bigger than the other.
Gee, how much worse could I get?
Not much, unless there were two of you.
I guess I'd better just go shoot myself then.
Oh, you don't have to do that. We have staff here that can do that for you. The doctor monitoring the human show, in fact, is a specialist in the field.
Human show? Hot dang, sign me up.
Sorry, humans can't sign themselves up, no matter how ugly they are. Go ask your owner to sign you up. Ask him to sign you up for a haircut while they're at it.
Hi, I'm Laverne.
That's regrettable. Perhaps you should see the doctor. Now be off with you. Humans aren't allowed to roam free here. I'm taking you back to the kennel.
Boy, I wish I had a tentacle costume or something, but I can't even sew. Yoo-hoo, Mr. Tentacle Guy.
What?
I have to go to the bathroom.
Ha, that's a good one. Imagine a human using a bathroom. Come on, let's take a walk. Okay, human, do your business.
Dum-de-dum. Looks like a big storm. See, this is why I never wash my car. Hey, Ben.
Oh, it's you.
Where are you going? What about your experiment?
Even science sometimes gets cold on account of rain, my boy.
But how are you ever going to get lightning if you're not going to stand out in a storm?
To be frank, which I am, I don't know. The science of electrodynamics, much like your mind apparently, is still in a state of relative infancy. Back to the drawing board, I say.
What a genius. Yo.
Hello?
What's up, you cold?
Cold? I'm freezing.
Why don't you build a fire?
Well, I keep asking Jefferson to build a fire, but he won't. Says he needs the log for posterity and won't part with it.
He's going to give the log to starving children?
I don't get any respect around here. Why, I bet if George I spent the winter in Valley Forge, Washington was called, we'd get some heat in here.
What are you guys doing in here?
We're writing
We're drafting a constitution for the United States.
Don't say draft. You'll only make me colder.
Wimp.
Why don't you build a fire?
Well, I keep asking Jefferson to build a fire, but he won't. Says he needs the log for posterity and won't part with it.
You mean it's like a symbol of growth or something?
I don't get any respect around here. Why, I bet if George I spent the winter in Valley Forge, Washington was called, we'd get some heat in here.
Well, I gotta go, dude. Hey, tall, dark, and spiffy, my name's Hoagie.
Well, how quaint. I am, of course, Thomas Jefferson, noted scholar, musician, horseman, student of the sciences, member of the bar.
Oh, sure, I've heard of you, dude. What's in the can, Tommy?
Thomas. My name is Thomas, and this, my chubby friend, is a time capsule. Filled with remembrances of our time to be revealed 400 years hence.
So, how's the time capsule going?
I'm sorry to say that except for my log, we haven't got a thing.
Dude, is that like the Constitution?
It is. Now that our esteemed leader has sparked us with his brilliant vacuum suggestion, we're really rolling. By tomorrow, we'll have finished all 9,800 amendments.
I hope they've got a good editor. Could you start a fire, please?
I'd love to oblige you, young man, but I can't. This is the only log, and I'm saving it for posterity.
How can you let Hancock suffer like that?
A real man is warmed by the fires of his spirit. You should listen to Washington relate his experiences at Valley Forge and take heed.
Has anyone ever told you you're a very snappy dresser?
Why, yes. I studied at Virginia Coat and Technical, where I majored in collar theory. I was captain of the varsity cravat team.
Those are impressive credentials, Tom.
Thomas.
Dude, I loved your work on the Declaration of Independence.
Ah, thank you. What was your favorite part?
I like the we the people part.
That's not in the Declaration of... Say, that's not bad. Maybe we can use it.
Well, later, dude.
What? What's going to happen later? Thank you. This is exactly the sort of thing I need for the time capsule. I'll bury it tonight, and it won't be seen for hundreds of years. Future generations are in your debt.
Whoa. Excuse me.
Yes?
Mr. President, may I offer you an excellent smoke?
Can you also provide me with a light?
Sure.
Well, in that case... Blast, I hate it when that happens. See if you can't find those for me, will you? There's a good lad.
told you guys I'll get to the flag next. I'm working as fast as I can.
Hey, chill. Take your time.
Don't tell me you've got another design change for the flag.
I've got another design change for the flag.
I knew it. What's the current brainstorm from our fickle founding fathers?
It should have a hologram on it somewhere.
Oh, what the heck. At this point, I'd do anything just to have it over with. Put the pattern on the table, and I'll look at it when I'm done with this job.
Question is, which one's stuffed and which one's the real McCoy?
I assure you that we are both real, but we are neither one of us McCoys. We are Edisons, Ned and Jed.
Who's who?
Does it really matter? Even our dear father can't tell us apart. He only knows that one of us is left-handed while the other is right, but that neither of us are following in his tiny scientific footsteps. Hold still, Jed! So, I'm almost too frightened to ask, are you the marble delivery man? Or the model?
I'm no marble delivery man, but rock is my life.
I'm sure that's terribly amusing, where you're from. Where exactly did you come from?
The future. Kind of spooky sounding, ain't it? Ooh, the future. I'm from the future. Look out.
Gosh, it would be so nice if you weren't here anymore.
Sorry, hope I haven't jostled you.
Too late. Oh no! I've lost it! Where hath gone the muse that once guided my hand with such care? Must inspiration be so transitory? Must art be so cruel? I'm a failure. Don't say that, Ned. Father was right. We Edisons are made to be scientists, not artists. Dear brother, we must be strong in these times of creative adversity. Why don't you let me take over for a while? I'll clean this rubble up and start over. You relax. Have a cappuccino. I'm glad we switched places. I think you're coming out quite well.
Maybe we should add a rule that you can't dump sludge into the water supply.
What manner of fool would do that in the first place?
You're right.
Thank you.
Yoo-hoo, Mr. Tentacle Guy.
It's about time.
Yoo-hoo, Mr. Tentacle Guy.
What?
Ooh, I don't feel so good.
Again?
He might get upset. Hello, I'm a tentacle. I'd like to enter my insignificant human in the show.
Oh my, yes, yes, of course. Take these tags and put them on your human and have them wait on the bench in the lobby. Entrance will be judged in three categories. Best smile, best hair, and best laugh.
Thank you, fellow tentacle. Unlike humans, you have been very useful.
Oh, thank you. Believe me, it was my pleasure.
Now all I need is a human.
Yowza! That was one good-looking tentacle.
Stupid tentacle. Looks like there's some kind of rodent down there. You're ready to go now.
To go. Let's get this show on the road.
Ah, here it comes. My finest hour.
Thank you. chattering, Mummy. The judges will think you're chewing gum.
And that sound is giving me an headache.
Oh, this will never work. Oh, Harold, that's gross.
What are you babbling about?
You really should have told the judges if you weren't feeling well.
Oh, ick! Now how did that mess get in there? I think I'm going to be sick.
Someone in here not feeling well?
I was feeling fine until I saw that.
Is that your regurgitation?
No, I'm an LCU man. Didn't you just say you thought you were going to be sick? That's just a figure of speech.
Do you realize you could have infected the whole show with human influenza?
But I just got all my shots.
You're a good-looking human, Harold, but you know the rules. You're out of the show. What a mess.
I hate cleaning up after humans.
And so I said to her, that's not my suction cup.
Hey, when are you guys going to judge best hair?
Oh, all right.
Wow, that's the best hair I've ever seen on a mummy.
Thick and full.
And juicy.
The mummy wins.
Agreed.
Hey, when are you guys going to judge best left?
Oh, all right.
Okay, who's got a joke?
Hey, I just flew in from Baltimore, and boy are my suction cups tired.
A classic.
It's amazing how the mummy can do that without moving his lips.
I say we give him first place.
Agreed.
Hey, when are you guys going to judge best smile?
Oh, all right.
I like the quiet one with the big T.
There's nothing in the rules about them being white.
First place goes to the mummy.
Agreed.
Well, that makes him best of show.
Let's go congratulate him.
He is very well preserved.
I'll miss his laugh.
It's time to give him his winnings and start packing up. We gotta get this whole show to Baltimore by Thursday.
Yes, our work here is done.
Well, Ted, this is where we part ways. You've certainly helped save humanity. Even though you've been dead for thousands of years, I think you're my favorite Edison.
Thank you.
It shrunk to doll size. Gosh, I hope this isn't like the primitive, dangerous microwave ovens of my century. Those things could really pop a hamster good. Uh-oh. That was fun, but only because this is the 22nd century. You see, kids who put hamsters in microwaves back where I'm from get taken away from their parents and put up for adoption. So don't do it. This ought to warm him up. Nah, too messy.
Say, cutie, what brings a hot tentacle babe like you to a dump like this?
I'm here by accident. Bye.
Hey, I don't want to be here either. Whoa! Dinner for two at Club Tentacle? I can't wait to tell my wife.
I think I'll just see what these chattering teeth are up to. Whew, that was close. Excuse me.
What is it? I'm rather. Say, aren't you Bernard Bernoulli?
Yes, that's right.
I knew it! You broke into our mansion a few years ago to save your little friend. What did you come for this time?
I'm trying to keep a tentacle from conquering the world. How's Dr. Fred doing?
Well, he's still upset about the family financial situation, seeing that it's his fault and all. But he seems a lot better now that he stopped sleepwalking.
How did he wreck the family finances?
Well, we should have made millions on the computer game they made about us. But the resident genius locked the contract in the safe in his office and forgot the combination.
What's wrong with sleepwalking?
Ordinarily, nothing. But when Fred sleepwalks, he remembers a combination to the safe. I'd find him in the office, opening it, screaming like a cat in the oven, and slamming it again. Something about what's in there really scares him. Unfortunately, I was never able to catch the combination since he works it so fast.
How did he manage to stop sleepwalking?
He stopped sleeping. Fred drinks a lot of coffee. Me, I only drink decaf.
I was just admiring your statue.
Thank you. It's been in the Edison family since colonial times. One of Fred's ancestors carved it.
This is quite an array of gadgetry you have here.
Yes, it's the best surveillance system in the state.
I'll let you get back to what you were doing.
Come back anytime, you big hunk.
Well, you know what they say. If you want to save the world, you gotta push a few old ladies down the stairs. It's already rewound.
Dr. Fred Edison, Internal Revenue, come with us. We'd like to go over some of your records with you. Upstairs.
Let's see, it's 101-99957.
We'll be right back.
Thought I heard something. Everything okay in there? Well, try and keep it down, okay?
Nah, I'm not gonna make that mistake again. Oof. Dr. Fred, are you okay? Dr. Fred? I'd better get him to the lab. Well, I got him in here, but he's out cold. He's already unconscious. Decaf might kill him. But it's worth a try.
Damn good coffee.
Got the contract for you to sign, Doctor.
Sorry, I don't like to sign things that I haven't read.
Oh, forget it. I'll get rid of Purple Tentacle myself.
Oh, yeah? How?
I offered Purple Tentacle a bribe, and he took it.
Where did you get that kind of money?
I used one of your checks.
Brilliant! I'll just stop payment on it tomorrow.
Exactly. All I need now is your signature.
Well, good luck. Yes, what do you want?
Hi there. Is this Dr. Fred Edison?
Who did you think you called? Dr. Spock? Look, I don't have all day.
This is Farley Crock at LucasArts Games. I just discovered your contract among some very old files, and, well, our lawyers say that we have to pay you $2 million in back royalties. For the use of your family in the Maniac Mansion video game.
What?
This is Farley Crock.
No, I heard that, you moron. When do I get my money?
Oh, right now. It's been credited to your Swiss bank account.
Operator, Get me a travel agent! This is an emergency!
I need that for my super battery.
This ought to be good. Well, what do we have here? Looks like a prosthetic rodent. Another specimen. He's not even cooked.
Could you use these? Why, thank you, young man. Strange. I wonder if I should cut down on the coffee.
Hey, Tom, look! The father of our nation is cold. Better build a fire.
You're right. I guess you can have my log.
Me? Why should I build the fire? You build the fire.
I'm bothered by the smoke. You build the fire.
I'm bothered by your attitude. You build the fire.
No, you build the fire, Mr. Penmanship.
No, you build the fire, log lover.
No, you build the fire.
No, you build the fire.
You big baby!
Who was the idiot who started the fire?
I bet this never happens to Tom Paine. Yo, Penmaster.
I'm afraid we're a little busy right now.
I wonder what idiot started the fire. It looks pretty clear in here now. Say, did you get the pen on our way out?
No,
I found a blanket blocking the chimney.
Son, do you know anything about a blanket?
Didn't the dude next to you have one earlier? Hey, catch you later.
Element for my ingenious battery. Stand back, boy. Give me room to work. Miracle of modern science. It will look lovely here on the shelf until I take it with me to Baltimore.
Don't look now, but the British are coming, dude.
Eh? Where? Is that supposed to be funny? I'm very busy.
I got something good for you, mister. Mister.
Mr. Brainstorm? Yes, hand it over. Doesn't this belong to somebody?
Yeah, Red Edison.
Ah. I'm sorry, but the man has no vision. A lightweight, durable fabric like this going to waste down in his basement. When I'm done with it, it will fly. Eureka! The all-season flankocopter, ready to make history! No, there's no fuse!
So, what do I light?
For the last time, you're not going to light anything! You just push it!
The whole time? How am I going to get up that high?
Listen, just wait for me to say the word now. Then push the kite into the air, all right?
I'm on you, Lasagna.
Let's hope so. Now!
Whee!
He's handling kind of funny.
You got it. Just hang on there.
He's too heavy. I can't control her.
Hang on, Ben. Hang on.
She's breaking up. She's breaking up. Run for your life. Now that was interesting.
Yeah. Say, can I see that kite for a second?
No, I'm taking it back to my lab in Philly right now so I can study the results. Wish me luck! I never got your name.
It's Hoagie, sir.
Nice working with you, Hoagie. I promise to name an invention after you someday.
Gosh, thanks. Flush, my one chance of getting out of here? Yeah. Wow.
Feel about humans?
Honestly, sir, I think they're filthy, obscene, foul, sickening, like the stuff in your eyes when you wake up, like the wax that builds up behind your suction cups after a few days.
That's enough, son. I just wanted to be sure you weren't one of those humanist sympathizers. What with this ridiculous human show going on here, there's humophiles everywhere.
I'm no humophile, sir.
That's good. Now, let me tell you about a little plan I have.
Hey, look! A skunk.
Come back here, you mangy humans! You can't do this! This is an escape-proof facility!
Who says you can't learn anything from cartoons, eh, kitty? Now I am the jailer, and you kitty, are my prisoner. That sucker go! He just keeps running and running and running.
Couch Enter shopping channel. Wanda speaking.
I want to buy a diamond.
That will be $2 million. Do you have a major credit card?
I have a numbered Swiss bank account.
What's the number, sir?
It's 846-427-35327.
Very good, sir. We'll send the diamond by Pronto Post light speed delivery immediately. Thank you for calling.
Now that's service. Better get this to Dr. Fred right away.
That should do it. Where did you get this diamond anyway?
It was donated by a group of Girl Scouts who were in the neighborhood.
How heartwarming. According to my instruments, everything is in readiness. Your friends have activated their units, so it's time to throw the switch.
Great! Foggy! I'm so happy to...
Hi!
Laverne! Wow! I'm so glad you two made it back okay.
I hate to interrupt, but there's no time to lose. Now that you're back, we've got to proceed with the original plan and send you back to yesterday to turn off the sludge-o-matic!
Huh?
Say what?
Now hold on a minute, Dr. Fred. They just barely made it back to our time alive, and I think...
Ha ha! You can't turn off the machine if I get there first.
Don't worry, guys! This time I know I can stop it!
Uh-oh. I guess we better do something.
Let's go.
No, wait! You can't all go in the same store. Didn't you see the fly?
We're some kind of monster, dudes.
Great. Stuck here the rest of my life, listening to Bernard talking and watching Hoagie eat. Mom warned me there'd be days like this.
Now, wait just a minute. It's Green Tentacle. What was that green? What?
I believe he's trying to warn you about me.
Oh.
We're going to turn off the sludge-o-matic and defeat your evil plan, overgrown worm.
You sorry lot are no match for me.
But there's three of us. Well, sort of.
Nevertheless, I mean to crush you.
Yeah?
You and what army?
Why, this army, of course.
Yikes.
You see, I've been busy. These are all versions of myself from the future. I've been bringing them back here using the Chronojon. Together, we will conquer the world. You head there. Go to the basement and guard the sludge-o-matic. To touch the sludge-o-matic. Now, creature, I must decide what excruciating tortures to. Leave them to me. I've been itching for a chance to test out my newly completed diminuator.
Uh-oh.
Excuse me. Us.
All right, the rest of you come with me. Next stop, the world.
What do we do now?
Whoa.
It wears off.
Aha!
Run for it!
Damn. The battery must not have had time to recharge, but it will.
Maybe he won't find us.
Yoo-hoo, where are you, human? I think I've almost got it working. Always conks out as I'm about to finish them off.
It's way too high. Where'd he go? Excuse us.
What is it?
Which one of you is the real Purple Tentacle?
We all are, Dopey. Weren't you paying attention earlier? Now, buzz off.
Turn off the machine and prevent all this tentacle mayhem from ever happening.
Well, I'm certainly glad that's over with.
Yeah, let's get out of here.
Leaving so soon? We haven't had the chance to get to know one another. Your efforts are so tiny.
Eek!
Run all you like, you insignificant insect. You can't stop me.
Just what is it you have against humans, anyway?
Humans are our oppressors. They made us live in this horrible motel. They created us in ungainly forms, so we could not rise against them. Try walking around with your legs tied together and glue on your shoes, you'll see what I mean.
So?
You wouldn't understand.
Let's discuss your hatred of humans further.
What's to talk about? I detest the whole cackling, hand-wringing lot of you.
But humans created the sludge-o-matic, which made you super-intelligent.
Nonsense. I created that myself and sent it back through time. I knew Fred's mad scientist ego would make him use it. How's that for a paradox?
Oh, Fred? But there's only one of him.
Right. Anyway, you can see why I detest humans.
Let's discuss your hatred of humans further.
What's to talk about? I detest the whole cackling, hand-wringing lot of you.
Sounds like you just hate Dr. Fred.
I suppose you're right about that. I didn't start out hating all humans, just Dr. Fred.
You're pretty handy with that ray gun.
Center of the forehead every time. Would you like a demonstration?
Why don't you zap Dr. Fred if you hate him so much?
Perhaps that would be entertaining.
Surely.
Wait! You haven't heard the last of me. I'll be back, and the next time, the world and all its piffling inhabitants shall be mine. All mine. All mine.
Okay, little fella. Mail this to Siberia. Our work here is done. Now we can go home.
Well, kiddies, it's been more fun than a jumpsuit full of weasels. Now kindly get your freakish hide out of my home.
Please, Dr. Fred, you've got to get us out of this mess. We look terrible, and we can't buy clothes off the rack.
I'm getting sort of used to it. Maybe we could go on the talk show circuit.
Help us, Dr. Edison. You're our only hope.
Oh, all right. Exactly the sideshow attraction you imagined. You're just three complete goofballs stuck in one suit of clothes.
I'm glad that's taken care of. Looks like everything's back to normal.